Hey guys, I have kettlebell yoga number 2 for you today. I think this is again going to be really fun and uniquely challenging, and it just combines two of my most enjoyable types of exercise and, you know, in one great package, and it's just really fun and interesting to me. I hope you enjoy it too. Let's get to it.
So we're going to start with two sun salutations. So arms up overhead, hands down in front of your feet, look at your knees, going to flat back, hands in front of your feet, jump back to plank, shoulders forward, push up, tuck your feet, roll forward, upward dog, tuck your toes, hips up, downward dog. And we just do one more. We're just doing this to warm up a little bit. Hands to your feet, straighten the legs, look at your knees, and reverse the movement. And one more. Arms up overhead, hands in front of your feet, look at your knees, up, flat back, hands down, jump back to plank, feet, shoulders past the wrists, push up, tuck your feet, roll forward, upward dog, tuck your toes, hips up, down. I forgot to set my timers. Let's start them now. Okay. I'm gonna do 20 one-arm swings. So you swing and switch after each rep. If you can't do that, just do 10 on one side, 10 on the other. If you can't do that, just do 20 swings. It's okay. I'm just mixing it up. So ready from the hips. 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. And now we're going to do the chair squat. So, you're going to put your hips back like you're sitting in a chair. I like to start with my feet not together, and then when you get into the movement, then bring your feet closer together. Just so that we can squat with our hips back as far as possible. So, really get a good squat like this. Now, bring your feet together, or as close as you can. Stay in this movement. Make sure that you can lift your toes up. You don't want to be leaning forward in this, putting pressure on your knees, but bringing your knees past your toes. And we're gonna hold this. It's a very warm day today. So, hand to this. This is challenging. A couple more deep breaths. Keep your back straight. Try not to come out of it. If you have to straighten your legs for a second, do that and then get back into it. One more. Straighten the legs. I feel it in my arms too. Woo! I held that longer than I thought I could, though, so that's good. Okay, now we're doing another definitely not easy move. Get your kettlebell. Goblet jump lunges. For these, if you can't do the jump, just do regular backward lunge, holding the kettlebell at your chest. I'm gonna do the jump, because I like to make things crazy. Be very careful if you don't feel stable or comfortable doing the jump, and don't smack yourself in the face. I'm holding it too high. 1, 2, 3, just 10 of them. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Woo! Okay. Now we're getting down. And we're gonna do plough and shoulder stand. Okay. So you're gonna roll your feet back over your head. And then from here, you're gonna walk your hands on up your back to support your back. And get your legs up straight as possible. Torso straight. If this is too much, stay in plough. Feel any stress in your neck, come out. I don't know how straight I was. Coming out. Back into plough if you want. And now we're going to roll forward into the standing squat. If you can't, just roll out and then stand up as you need to. I'm going to roll forward and get up. If you can't, just slowly roll forward, sit down, and then from sitting, help yourself up to standing. That's perfectly fine. Woohoo! Okay. I'm gonna do snatches. The snatch is a very advanced move. If you can't do the snatch, because you're just swinging right up into the racked position on your hand, on your wrist and arm, do clean and press. I'll show you the clean and press first. So if you want to do that, grab the kettlebell pointing towards you, swing it up into the clean, press. And then we're going to come back down and swing again, clean, press again for each rep. All right? But I'm going to do snatches. If you can, do it with me. If not, do the clean and press. Ready, snatch. 10 on each side. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Do not try this for the first time in this workout. Don't bang it against your arm. If any of that's happening, don't do it. Be smart, don't hurt yourself. Okay, 10 on this arm. 1, 2, with control. 3, don't let it bang. 4, fun but tough balance combination one. We're gonna do Lord of the Dance. 5 on each leg to 1 leg deadlift. So we're just gonna stay on 1 leg for 5 reps to just really get a good burn on each side. So I'm gonna start standing on my right leg, grab the left foot, the left hand, reach out with the right. And you're gonna press the leg back. Back and up. I always have trouble doing this while talking. You're gonna press the leg back and up as much as you can. And as you're arching back and pressing and standing back with the leg, you're gonna just naturally lean forward with the upper body. But don't lean forward first. Wait until you're just naturally that's naturally happening. Okay. Try to keep the leg up. If you have to tap the toes, it's okay. Grab a kettlebell. And deadlift. Back down. And dance again. Deadlift. That's two. More of the dance. Three. Two more. Feeling the burn. Or oh, last one. Fight through the burn. I am. Oh, it's five. Oh, shake it out. Yeah, do five on the other side. Okay. So now stay on the left leg. Right hand, right foot, left arm out. This is my bad side. It's two. I gotta watch my balance. Come on. Try to only touch with the toes so you're not totally taking the weight and pressure off the standing leg. All right. Three. Two more. My balance. Okay. Oh, it's four. And last one. With strength. I'm strong enough. I can't balance. I'm just gonna do the best I can. Okay, it's the best I can do right now. Can't have this go on forever. And five. Oh my god. Okay, now we're gonna do bow. Get down on the ground. On your belly. That was tough. I know. That really challenged me too. That was way harder than I thought it was going to be. Alright, so bend your knees. Grab the outside. Well, grab from the outside of the foot grab the inside of the foot from the outside with each hand. Keep your knees as close together as you can. They don't have to be touching now. And you're gonna rise up in your chest and your hips and try to stay on your belly. If you rest on your pubic bone in this, it is gonna hurt like almighty hell. That's always my problem with it. So really try to stay on your belly button on the ground, and just raise everything evenly. Raise up as much as you can.
Ready?
Let's go. Back up. I'm gonna do Russian swings. So for these, it's just a regular swing, but it comes up a little bit higher, bring it up to your chest. So just really hinge from the hips. Okay. 20 of these. So shoulders back. Okay, now dolphin. Dolphin's really tough. Get down. Forearms on the ground. Straight, shoulder width apart. And you don't want your shoulders to go back behind over the elbows or forward past the elbows. You want to keep your shoulders and upper body involved and engaged in this. And we're going to stand up. The hips. And bring the feet in as close as you can. And hold. Down. I'm not good at dolphin, but that's why I wanted to work on it. Okay, now we're gonna do 20 figure eights. This is the last move with the kettlebell. For this, you can stay in the squat or squat for each rep. I'm gonna stay in the squat, it burns more, but I'll show you the squatting every rep. You're going to take kettlebell in the right hand and you squat down, pass it underneath the left leg into the left hand, stand up, then you squat down, pass it underneath, around the left leg, underneath the right leg into the right hand, and stand up and keep going like that. It weaves an eight around your legs. I'll show you a couple real quick. One, two, three, four, okay. I'm gonna stay down and squat the whole time and do it. Be careful not to bang against your legs. Be very aware of how you're moving the kettlebell. And, okay, 20 of them. Two, three, four, five, 7, 8, 20. And sit. Okay. Now we're just gonna do garland. So, deep squat. As low as you can. If you have trouble here, getting your heels down, work on that. If you're comfortable with me, bring your feet together and put your forearms down. And let's hang out here. And breathe. Stand with the whole foot. The whole foot needs to be flat from the heel to the toe. Work on that if that is not happening for you. Just work on letting the hips open that up for you. We're almost done. Almost done with this workout. It's gonna be like a 20-minute workout. Or a little more, I'm not sure how long sun salutations at the beginning took. At the timer started, I imagine only like a minute. Just hold this. Another couple breaths. Just try to get comfortable, sink into it. See, I'm not staying still. Wiggling and adjusting. Trying to get as good, deep a stretch as I can. Wider again. Stay here. And straighten the legs. Slowly come up. And we're just going to do the really nice legs up the wall. If you have a wall, go scoot close to it. Put your butt literally against it so that you're as close as possible to it. Scoot your butt up against it and legs up straight. Don't point your toes up like towards the sky. Point the toes towards you so you flex the foot, make it flat. And arms out and hang out here. Feels amazing. My cat's meowing to get out. We're almost done. Almost done, Key. She sleeps while I work out in the room with her and then wonders why I won't stop in the middle of the routine. Silly cat. Just another deep breath. You can hold this as long as you want. It's a really nice release for the legs. If you're done, slide the legs down to the ground. And slowly get up. Oh, and we're done. My timers tell me like 22 minutes. I'm gonna say it was like 23.
Cause I'm not sure how long the sun salutations in the beginning were. Whatever, it's okay. So just a little over 20 minutes for this amazing workout. This was a lot harder than I thought it was gonna be. Excuse me. A lot more fun. I feel really good right now. I'm sweating like crazy. Let me know what you thought. I'm still loving this combination of kettlebell and yoga, you know, and stretching and everything for a series. So I want to keep making them. So let me know if you're on board with that, if you like it too. I'm really enjoying it. I hope you are. Leave me a comment and let me know. I'll give you a really detailed workout breakdown at jiggityjack.com, so come look for that. I got recipes, nutrition, all kinds of good stuff over there. I have something I'm going to be offering very soon that I'm working on all kinds of good stuff. So just stick with me, sign up for the newsletter, and like, subscribe, and share here, and just let me know your thoughts. Let me know how you're liking this, if you're hating it, if you want something totally different, or if you want more of this. All right, hope you enjoyed it. See you next time, guys. Thanks.